bells of Notre Dame.
The fisherman fishes.
The baker man bakes to the bells of Notre Dame.
To the big bells as loud as the thunder.
To the little bells soft as a song.
And some say the soul of the city's the toll of
the bells.
Gathered at the cathedral
to listen to the sermon
of Dom Claude Frollo,
Archdeacon of Notre Dame,
before whom the congregation trembled as he stalked beneath the lofty arches of the church.
Congregants, we gather here in this vast symphony of stone on the morning of the Feast of Fools. Our streets will soon be filled with those unsavory elements, criminals, foreigners, and gypsies who have infested our streets and are on this one day free to roam without being subject to arrest. We must resist the temptations of those less devout than we. We must fight the urge to indulge ourselves, for remember, we are all born sinners.
Long years ago did this story begin in this place called Notre Dame.
Two orphaned brothers were both taken in by the grace of Notre Dame.
Claude the older, who cared for his brother,
young Jean, full of beauty and charm.
And they lived and they grew and awoke to the music of
arches and this sacred door. We are blessed to find our sanctuary and our home.
Come with me, brother. I'm headed into town for a little fun.
Jayon, no. You must stay home and run out your catechism.
No, you must come with me to the ball.
Jayon! I'm not going to lie for you again if you stay out late.
Yes, you will. Brother dear, you're so good to me.
Righteous Claude Frollo was ever more drawn like a son to Notre Dame.
Not like his profligate brother Jean, who'd have none of Notre Dame.
Though as brothers they loved one another, Frollo watched in despair and alone.
As Jean grew more wild and defiled all the laws.
The laws of Notre Dame.
Jayon, where have you been? Why weren't you at evening mass?
Brother, it's your birthday. We must celebrate. I've brought you a gift. She's a friend of mine.
A gypsy girl in our room?
Florica. She's a beauty, isn't she? This is my brother, Claude.
Oh. Happy birthday, Claude. Oh. Come, don't be so shy. I can see you want to. I can see it in your eyes. Oh, I can feel it, too.
Stop!
Claude! It's Father Dupin. Help me hide her.
What's going on in here?
Nothing, Father.
Is it nothing, Claude?
Tell him, Jayon. If you won't, I will!
You must leave, Jayon, this holy refuge where you've dwelled.
Leave? But Father!
Sorry, Claude, but I've no choice. Your brother is expelled.
Jayon.
Oh! What did you think? That they wouldn't send me away? Who do you think these people are?
These people have given us a home and comfort and safety.
Oh, comfort, yes. You call this comfort. You call this safety? Well, you're welcome to it. You can have it. And Jeon!
And the girl.
Left.
And Frollo didn't hear from his brother for several years.
Meanwhile,
Frodo ascended uncommonly fast through the ranks of Notre Dame,
till he was named the archdeacon at last and gave thanks
to Notre Dame.
And then one doleful day brought a message,
and the name that it bore was Jeon.
And concealing his face, Frodo stole to a place far away.
Away from Notre Dame.
I was told to come to this place. I'm Father Claude Frollo.
Ah, we've heard of you.
Hello, brother dear.
Jeon, where have you been?
Traveling, hounded from city to city with my beautiful Florica.
That gypsy girl, you're with her.
She died 6 weeks ago. The pox. Terrible thing to watch her suffer.
Jeon, let me take you back. Let me bring you home.
Brother dearest, come with me where we will find the remedy, and Notre Dame once more will be your sanctuary. Healing you will be my goal. Not just your body, but your soul. We'll be together in our holy sanctuary.
Enough, Claude. Enough of your pieties. It's too late for me anyway. But if you've truly discovered charity at this late date, there's someone you can help.
A baby? Yours? Oh! A monster. It's God's judgment on you. The wicked shall not go unpunished.
I should have known. I was a fool to think that you would look after him.
Look after him? Me?
He has nobody else.
But he's a gypsy child.
And mine. Take him. If you can find it. In your heart.
Jeon. Jeon! Sent me a test. This child is my cross to bear. I may not have saved my brother, but I will save this thing. But a creature like this must be kept hidden.
See this loathsome creature from whom lesser men would flee. Keep and care for him and teach him at my knee. To think like me.
And Frollo gave the child a name.
A cruel name that means
half form.
Quasimodo.
Now here is a riddle to guess if you can. Sing the bells of Notre Dame.
What makes a monster and what makes a man?
What makes a monster and what makes a man?
Sing the bells.
voice today. Francois, we need to fix your clapper. Go on, Gabriel, sing. Pour your flood of sound into this square below. It's a holiday. Sing, my bells. Sing till you're all quite out of breath. Hello, my birdies.
For Quasimodo, the cathedral was not only his home, but his entire universe.
It was peopled with figures of marble.
With kings and saints.
Monsters and demons.
And the saints blessed him.
And the monsters protected him.
And he understood them.
And they understood him.
Don't you wish you could be like those birds and just fly away?
Me? No.
But how wonderful it must be out there.
Not for me, no.
The boy is right. Don't encourage him.
Why shouldn't we?
Today is the Feast of Fools.
Quasimodo, why don't you try going down there?
But you know I've never gone out there before.
You can leave anytime you want.
Master won't allow it.
Last year, he said someday, maybe.
Well, he always says someday, but never today.
Besides, you don't need to ask for permission to go outside. Just put one foot in front of the other
and sneak out.
No, I can't.
Quasimodo? Good morning, Quasimodo.
Good morning, Master.
Talking to someone?
No. Just my friends.
Ah, your friends. Tell me, Quasimodo, what are your friends made of?
Stone!
And can stone talk back?
No.
That's right. What kind of a conversation is that? It takes two people to communicate, my boy. And who is that other person for you?
You, Master!
Right again. Corpus Christi.
Amen.
Sanguis Christi.
Amen.
In nomine Patris et Filii Spiritus Sancti. I brought a special treat this morning. Strawberry.
Ooh.
Ah. Self-control, Quasimodo. It is important that we master the art. And of manners, too.
Thank you, Master.
Now, shall we tell today's story? Stories from our home's beautiful statues, and we were up to
flight into it.
Right. Now tell me, what do you remember about that story?
Joseph fled to Egypt.
Yes, with his wife, Mary, and
baby Jesus.
Yes. Now tell me, who hid them? Who protected them?
Saint Afro.
Aphrodisius. Saint Aphrodisius. Just as I have hidden and protected you. Ah, well, I suppose I must stop stalling. Oh, look at them down there. Like horrible vermin, scuttling about and all to hear the gypsies sing and dance.
Gypsies? You told me gypsies were not allowed to sing and dance.
Oh, well, they're not, except for on this one day, the Feast of Fools.
The Feast of Fools?
This will be the last time if I have anything to say about it.
Last time?
I've petitioned the king to stop next year's festival.
Then I can never go.
Why our king allows these gypsies to roam the streets is beyond me. Through borders porous as a sieve, we let them come and let them live. It's almost as if they were given sanctuary. How it fills me with disgust to walk among them, yet I must. I loathe to leave you and our trusty sanctuary.
What if I went with you? I could protect you.
You. Protect me.
Yes, yes, Master. Like Saint Afro. Saint Afro.
Saint Aphrodisius. I'm sorry, my boy. I don't mean to laugh at you. It's just that's what others would do. And worse. The world is cruel. The world is wicked. It's I alone whom you can trust in this whole city. I am your only friend. I who keep you, feed you, teach you, dress you. I who look upon you without fear. Why invite their curses and their consternation? Stay in here, away in here. Remember what I taught you, Quasimodo. You are deformed.
I am deformed.
And you are ugly.
And I am ugly.
It is a crime for which the world shows little pity. You do not comprehend.
You're my defender.
Out there, they revile you as a monster.
I am a monster.
Out there, they will hate and scorn and jeer.
You'll be a monster.
Why invite their curses and their consternation? Stay in here. Be faithful.
I'm faithful.
Grateful.
And grateful.
Do as I say. Obey and stay. Remember, Quasimodo, this is your sanctuary.
My sanctuary.
Safe behind these windows and these parapets of stone, gazing at the people down below me. All my life I've watched them as I hide up here alone, hungry for these histories they show me. All my life I memorize their faces, knowing them as they will never know me. All my life I wonder how it feels to pass a day not above them, but part of them, and of their living in the sun. Give me one day of air. All I ask is one to hold forever of air, where they all live on. Where what I give, what I care, just to live one day. Among the millers and the weavers and their wives, through the roofs and gables I can see them. Every day they shout and scold and go about their lives, heedless of the gift it is to be them. If I were in their skin, I'd treasure every instant out there, strolling by the sin. Taste of morning out there, like ordinary men who freely walk up out there. Just one day, and then I swear I'll be content with my share. Won't resent, won't despair, old and bent, I won't care. I'll have spent one day out there.
here.
Where it's twice as noisy as the bells.
Somehow, I can wander through this helter-skelter without fear now. No one sees I'm here now, out here in the world.
As Quasimodo turned into the square, he saw before him a ragged beggar.
Approached a haughty-looking gentleman.
You take pity, anything you can spare.
First of the day.
And plenty more to come. Clopin's beautiful, ladies and gents.
King of the gypsies.
A wild boar among domestic swine. Gypsies, let's get to work.
Once a year, we throw a party here in town. Once a year, we turn all Paris upside down. Every man's a king and every king's a clown. Once again, it's topsy-turvy day. It's the day the devil in a sketch released. It's the day we mock the prig and shock the priest. Everything is topsy-turvy at the feast of fools.
Topsy-turvy!
Drums and blow the trumpet!
Topsy-turvy!
Join the bums and thieves and strumpets streaming in from Chardis to Calais!
Scurvy knaves are extra scurvy on the 6th of January!
Oh, because it's Topsy-Turvy Day!
Hey!
Into the crowd strode a young cavalier, Captain Phoebus de Marton. At your service.
Whose dashing manner?
And bold swagger.
Could not quite conceal the haunted look in his eyes.
New to Paris, just back from the front.
One of those handsome fellows to whom all the girls take a liking.
Oh, well, thank you, ladies. Might one of you enjoy showing me around?
Captain, we aren't those kind of girls.
I like all kinds of girls. 4 years at the front give a man a zest for a little rest and recreation, for the chance to hunt for the spiciest in the way of rest and recreation. Give me your girls a pleasure, your grapes of Merlot. Show me your wares and measure, one large sample. Sample them at my leisure. This 3 day furlough should be ample. I have borne the brunt of a soldier's test. Now I've made my way where I get to play at rest and recreate. Ah. You're quick, but I'm quicker.
I don't want any trouble.
Neither do I, believe me. 4 years at the front. 4 years at the front.
Cannon fodder lying in the field below the castle. Is this the 3rd week or the 4th week of the siege?
Air filled with a stench, bodies in a trench.
Most I call my liege.
Summon here to Paris, now I'm far away from battle, from clotting blood and rotting wounds of dead and dying men. And whatever I do, I'll make sure this is true.
I will never go back again. Darling, to be blunt, you are with the best. That's why I've been blessed with this promotion. I've been working hard. Now I'm gonna be the captain of the guard. Ain't that a notion? Like other true knights, I've got ambition. But for a few nights, fun is my mission. So what do you say? Care to share a day at rest and recreation?
Come back here!
And where do you think you're going in such a hurry?
I did nothing wrong.
No? Then why run away from it so quickly?
Take pity, I'm just a poor fellow.
Oh, that pity be as well placed as a feather on a pig's ass.
My goodness, sir.
Beg your pardon, your grace.
What is going on here?
This gypsy picked my pocket.
Search him, Lieutenant.
Nothing on him, your grace.
They work in pairs. I couldn't catch the other one.
Arrest him.
On what charge?
For plying his trade. If it were up to me, he wouldn't be allowed on the streets at all. Or better yet, he'd be hunted for sport like the little gypsy dog he is. Take him away.
Our seeking fellow, I am Captain Phoebus de Marton.
Captain, only just arrived and already caught yourself a criminal. You waste no time. Welcome to the Cathedral Guard.
Oh, I'm grateful for the opportunity to serve you, my lord.
Your arrival is most auspicious. The pestilence of these gypsies grows more prevalent each day. Captain, you and I have a task we share, stopping them in their proliferation. Paris looks to us,
in
our streets of crime.
Streets of crime.
This is war, and thus there is no time for rest and recreation.
Come on, come on.
Hurry, hurry, here's your chance. See the mystery and romance.
Come on, come on.
See the finest girl in France make an entrance to entrance. Dance the Esmeralda.
Siren flaming inspire. Come see me dance. Hey, what can it hurt? It's just a dance to the rhythm of a
Esmeralda, so I've been told you come with useful tools. You'll thrive in Paris, Esmeralda, as long as you learn to follow our rules.
I'm afraid I've never been too good at following rules, monsieur.
So I have been told. Just stay out of trouble. Otherwise, you will find yourself off to the next town.
We're ready. Make yourself useful and line up the other men.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, for the piece de resistance!
Yes!
Here it is, the moment you've been waiting for. Here it is, you know exactly what's in store. Now it's time we laugh until our sides get sore. Now it's time we crown
the King of Fools!
You all remember last year's king? That's ugliest will be the King of Fools. Why?
Topsy-turvy!
Ugly folks, forget your shyness.
Topsy-turvy!
You can soon be called your highness.
Put your foulest features on display. Be the King of Topsy-turvy Day.
Are you going to join the competition?
Topsy-turvy!
Wouldn't you like to be crowned king for a day?
Topsy-turvy!
Why not take advantage of what you've got?
Topsy-turvy!
Oh! Oh! Is that a mask?
It's his face!
Oh, my God, he's hideous!
It must be the Hunchback!
From the bell tower!
Our chicken follows that! No wonder he gets him hidden!
His secret friend!
Ladies and gentlemen, please! We are in luck. We asked for the ugliest face in all of Paris.
And we found him!
Quasimoto! The Hunchback of Notre Dame!
Everybody, once a year we throw a party here in town.
Hail to the king!
Once a year we turn all Paris upside down.
Oh, what a king!
Once a year the ugliest will wear the crown.
Girls, get
the once a year on Topsy-Turvy Day. It's the day we do the things that we deplore. On the other 364, once a year we love to drop. With a beer, it's never stopping. For a dance, who pops and pops and jays. And crying, who puts the top in Topsy Turvy Day. Topsy Turvy, that crazy upsy daisy, Topsy Turvy Day.
Oh, you think that's ugly?
Watch this.
What are you doing? Oh,
now that's ugly.
Hail to the king.
Long live the king.
Bon appetit.
Your crowd had never done this before. Not in all the years of the Feast of Fools.
But they had never seen a creature so horrible.
And it drove them wild.
Get him!
A loud laugh burst from the mob as they beheld Quasimodo's naked hump
and hairy and scaly shoulders.
No, Master, please! Help me, Master, please! Master!
No, stop that!
What are you doing? Are you crazy?
Let go of me!
I'm warning you, Esmeralda, this is no way to start your time!
Stop! Please don't be afraid.
What?
Please.
What are you doing?
Ruining all of our fun.
Dirty gypsy!
Gypsy whore! I warned you, didn't I? Get up!
Where'd they go? Witchcraft!
Get him!
We must stop this at once! We must show kindness to this creature. Just as our savior did when he healed the lepers. Now this performance is over. Everyone go home, now!
Fischer Lecomte.
See how it's cruel, see how it's wicked, see why I sheltered you from having to go through this. How could you do this to me?
Forgive Master, won't ever go out again.
Now, boy, you see you don't belong with normal men. You are happy when you're in your sanctuary.
Sanctuary.
Back to your sanctuary. Never to come out here again. Take the boy inside.
The poor hunchback retreated back in through the doors of Notre Dame.
And there followed the gypsy girl who'd never been through the doors of Notre Dame. And she stopped in the hill of beauty, like a beggar receiving an alms.
And each window and pillar and arch seemed to fill her with love.
So, a gypsy dares enter this holy place.
Why not?
Because your kind aren't allowed in here.
Why? What did we ever do to you?
More than you know. What are you doing here?
I came here to find that boy. It's my fault he got up on that stage in the first place.
That boy is not your responsibility. He is my charge. God loves even a monster.
He seems no less human than the rest of us.
Some of us are less human than others, in the moral sense.
Do you mean me?
You dance without shame or modesty.
I dance because I enjoy it, and others enjoy it too and give me money.
As they would a woman of ill repute. Tell me, do you also deny possessing black magic?
If I had the power of magic, why wouldn't I use it to help myself and my people?
You're very clever. You twist the truth just as you twist your body and dance.
Your Grace, there must be some charity inside you. If you help that boy, then surely you can help others almost as unfortunate. How you would wish others to treat you, could you not treat them?
Our Lord Jesus said something very similar. Tell me, do you see him on the cross there, staring down at us? Midday Mass is starting. I must go. My child, though your people are lost, there may be something in you that can be saved. Please, stay. And maybe perhaps you will see what true beauty is. And we can continue this conversation afterwards.
Thank you.
see they don't find on earth. God help my people, they look to you still. God help the outcast, nobody will.
I ask for wealth,
I ask for faith,
for glory to shine on my name.
I ask for love I can possess.
I ask for God and His angels to bless me.
I ask for nothing I can get by. Less lucky than I. Please help my people, the poor and downtrodden. I thought we all were the children of God. God help the outcast.
Thought you disappeared in a puff of smoke.
Don't believe everything you see.
Where are you going?
Hoop! Relax.
Give me a chance to apologize.
For what?
This.
Oh.
Still, I'm impressed. You fight as well as almost any man.
Funny. I was going to say the same thing about you.
Oh. Look. It's my job to protect this cathedral.
From dirty gypsies like me?
You said it. I didn't. But I do have my orders to follow.
And if there's one thing every good soldier knows, it's how to follow orders.
Well, who said anything about being a good soldier?
Are you saying you're not?
What I'm saying is that I have a job to do. It's much better than the one it got me out of.
Burying your comrades in unmarked graves? You can look me in the eye, you know. We don't cast spells.
I know that. Where are you from, anyway?
You're asking a gypsy. All I know is I come from nothing, just like you.
Where are you going?
To see that boy.
Why can't you just mind your own business?
It has to be somebody's business. Hello? Are you up here? Hello?
Quasimodo, quick!
You have to hide!
You got to run!
Quasimodo!
Mustn't let her find
no,
you!
Mustn't! Find a place and quickly so she can see where you've gone!
Here she comes!
I think she's right behind you.
This way!
Over there!
Climb up here!
This way!
Find a place!
Too late!
Please, don't be afraid. I am so sorry about what happened to you. What an amazing place. Are you all alone up here? Hello? You can't hear me, can you?
Can hear a little, but read lips.
I thought I heard you when I came up here.
Oh, not me, the gargoyles.
The gargoyles? They speak to you?
Everything speaks to me. Gargoyles, stone statues, No, that's stupid.
No, it's not stupid. I like your friends. Have you lived here a long time?
Whole life.
Really? It seems like a wonderful place to live.
Yes, but in the winter, cold. You can see everything from up here. City gates, the River Seine.
Yes, it sparkles in the light. One small problem, though. I'm afraid of heights. Oh, thank you. You're very strong.
Yes, I am.
Still, I'm glad I can get to see things down there.
Gazing down from the top of the world, suddenly seeing a different city. Things look tiny and friendly and fair, seen from the top of the world. When you look from high above, everything seems pretty. Seeing life from the top of the world, nothing needs fighting and no one needs pity. Thanks for giving this moment to me, when just for a moment things stop. Here at the top of the world.
For all these years,
you've stayed alone
and free from danger.
We shared your fears.
It wasn't safe to trust a stranger.
This girl appears,
and she is kind, and we're admitted.
We give three cheers to see you all forever sitting. Look at you sitting on top of the world.
Seeing life from the top of the world,
she is
nothing
kind.
Needs fighting, and no one needs.
Be brave and say something.
Please don't think twice.
Quasimodo, say something.
Miranda.
Yes?
I it's nice. The two of us sitting.
The two of us sitting.
The two of you sitting. Sitting on top.
Today was going to be a special one. No, and look up there, hot lead.
Hot lead?
Yes, I fix all the bells. Come, I show you.
Quasimodo, what are you doing? Since when have you ever... My child. I looked for you after mass. I thought you had left. But it seems my charge here has distracted you. Quasimodo, you shouldn't have.
No, it was my fault, Your Grace.
My boy, don't you have duties to perform?
Yes! Master.
Don't stray too far. Filling the boy's head with dreams.
No, just thoughts. Nothing wrong with thoughts, is there?
Well, that depends. You can see how impressionable he is. He's little more than a child.
Looking at him, I don't see a child.
But you are. In a way. You indicated a willingness to learn. A soul that desires to be saved is already halfway there. I could share with you the Gospels, teach you in our Lord's graces. You could come here every day. Or Better yet, perhaps you could stay here.
Stay?
In the cathedral. With me.
I don't think that's such a good idea.
No?
I see the way you look at me.
How dare you! Your soul is so impure, you cannot even see the goodness in others. I should have known no gypsy would ever want to be saved.
I don't think I'm in need of saving.
Of course not! Your kind never do. Captain!
Your Grace!
I promise you, I could be a good friend, but also a terrible enemy. Escort this gypsy out of the cathedral. See to it she never steps foot in here again. If she does, she'll be arrested. Quasimodo?
Yes, master!
That gypsy girl.
Oh, she was so nice to me.
Was she? Now tell me, my boy, what do you know about people and their feelings?
Feelings? Nothing.
Quasimodo, have you ever had thoughts? Impure thoughts.
Impure thoughts.
A boy like you, already grown in body and possessing these thoughts and urges that come to a man, you must stop them. You must fight these urges. You must not follow in the same footsteps as your father.
My father!
He was weak! And you have his corruption inside of you. Quasimodo, I'm warning you. Stay away from her. She's dangerous. She was put in our paths to tempt us both. Promise me you won't think of her again.
I will.
Promise
me! I promise!
Good. Well then, we are well rid of her.
Yes, master.
It's just the two of us, my dear boy. You and I against the world.
Of course, master.
That's a good boy. Now, ring the bell and send the city to sleep. Good night.
Good night, master.
Despite his admonition to Quasimodo, Frollo himself could not stop thinking of her. He began to walk the streets night after night, unable to bring himself to return alone to his cold, dark chambers.
He barely knew what he was looking for. He could not resist.
He thought he saw her everywhere.
Quando birdosas, saimopias.
Until one night, walking down an unknown alley,
he drew closer to the most unsavory part of the city.
Passing lovers embracing in the shadows.
Until he came across the distant sound of music and laughter.
Come in from within a tavern called
La Pomme.
Sorry, but soldiers are not welcome here.
Relax. Just looking for a little rest and recreation.
All right, well, I'll see what I can arrange.
Actually, I'm looking for someone in particular.
And why does that not surprise me? But I'm afraid she's already spoken for.
Oh, really, Clopin? Nobody speaks for me.
I'm just looking out for your welfare.
I can look out for myself.
You lose friends easily, don't you?
I have that way about me.
Too bad. Makes finding you that much more difficult.
And does that disappoint you?
Does that surprise you?
Quite frankly, yes.
Me too.
Well, now that you've found me, what are you going to do about it?
I told you, I'm not as good as everyone likes to think.
In the dark of the night,
brazen, lewd, and odious, this vile depraved display.
In the dead of the winter,
bear to watch, and yet I cannot turn away.
You'll keep me warm until morning.
Well, that was pleasant. For you?
I have to go.
Where?
You're not the only one who needs to make money.
Where can I find you?
In the dark of the night, in the dead of the winter. Pleasure is clean.
There she is! I see her!
That isn't her?
Oh, no! Oh, I keep thinking I see her everywhere.
Oh, you're not supposed to think of her at all.
But I can't help it. I miss her.
Quasimodo, you can think of whoever you like.
Master says I must not.
He can't tell you what to think and not think.
Besides, you look out there every night.
Yes, but this is different. Everything is different now.
So many times out there, I've seen a happy pair of lovers walking in the night. They had a kind of glow around them. It almost looked like heaven's light. I knew I'd never know that warm and loving glow, though I might wish with all my might. No face as hideous as my face was ever meant for heaven's light. But suddenly an angel smiled at me and touched my face without a trace of fright. I dared to dream that she might even care for me, and as I ring the bells tonight, my cold dark tower seems so bright. I swear it must be heaven's light.
Of my virtue I am justly proud.
Pater.
Beata Maria, you know I'm so much purer than the common vulgar, weak, licentious crowd. Then tell me, Maria, why I see her dancing there, why her smoldering eyes still scorch my soul. I feel her, I see her, the sun caught in her raven hair is blazing in me out of all control. Like fire, hellfire, this fire in my skin, this burning desire is turning me to sin. It's not my fault, I'm not to blame. It is the gypsy girl, the witch who sent this flame. It's not my fault, if in God's plan he made the devil so much stronger than a man. Protect me, Maria, don't let this siren cast her spell. Don't let her fire sear my flesh and bone. Destroy Esmeralda, and let her taste the fires of hell, or else let her be mine and mine alone. Hellfire, dark fire, now gypsy, it's your turn. Choose me or your pyre.
On the very next morning, King Louis XI, nicknamed the Prudent,
received a visitor
who arrived unannounced.
Your Majesty.
My astrologer told me that I would have an unexpected guest.
Your Majesty, there is a gypsy girl who is terrorizing the people of Paris. I need special orders to protect the people and the church.
You are a good man, Frollo, but you know how I hate to be overly hasty.
I do, Your Majesty. It's just, I think you ought to be overly cautious so as not to appear weak. And if the burghers in the city wanted to gain the upper hand...
Very well. Very well. Do what you feel you must, but be well...
Prudent. I assure you, Your Majesty, I will do only... what is necessary.
By royal edict, warrant of arrest, the gypsy known as Esmeralda, being under suspicion of sorcery, witchcraft, and the art of hell. Anyone found harboring or helping her will be charged as well.
His Majesty has ordered the arrest of the gypsy girl. The Cathedral Guard will join the King's soldiers to help find her.
The Cathedral Guard? But we hold no military power.
Ah, but we do now, by His Majesty's own authority. I trust I can count on you to deliver her to me.
Absolutely. Your Grace.
Hunt down the gypsy Esmeralda. Don't let her flee and vanish in the night. These are the flames of Esmeralda. While she is free, your torches will burn bright.
Hunt down the gypsy Esmeralda. Don't let her flee and vanish in the night. These are the flames of Esmeralda. While she is free, our torches will burn bright.
Have no fear, my boy. We will find her, and we will capture her. The wicked shall not go unpunished. The heart of the wicked is of little worth. The wicked shall not go unpunished.
Through the city at more fevered pitch than the bells of Notre Dame.
Peace is for the one who leads us to Esmeralda.
Esmeralda, the witch with the might of Notre Dame.
4 gold pieces for the one who leads us to Esmeralda.
Till at last they were told of a brothel
where they sometimes hid gypsies from harm.
But the madam, that whore, denied it and swore by the saints.
The saints of Notre Dame.
We're looking for La Esmeralda.
Never heard of her. But perhaps one of my girls can be of service.
Ah, Captain Phoebus, it's nice to see you again.
Is this your establishment?
Yes, and a man like you shouldn't be here sullying his pristine reputation.
No one else is left, Your Grace.
Then she must be cleverly hidden. If you want your building to remain standing, give us the gypsy girl.
I know nothing of gypsies.
Very well. We'll set fire to it then. And if, as you claim, it is empty, it won't matter if we bar the doors as well.
No! No, you mustn't!
A lesson needs to be learned here. Burn it. Did you hear me, Captain?
And he held the torch that crackled like the gypsy's voice.
Are you disobeying a direct order?
And he knew this was the moment he must make a choice.
I knew it. She's bewitched you too. You throw away a promising career. Captain! Carry out the order.
God help the outcasts, for nobody will.
Ah, traitor gypsies, pawn, you're relieved of your patrol.
Consider it my highest honor.
Kyrie eleison, God have mercy on your soul. Lieutenant, you are in charge. Arrest Captain Phoebus.
No!
You see, there she is. Stab the captain! Seize them both! Huh. Witchcraft! You all saw that! We need to find them! Find them if that means you have to burn down all of Paris!
Good people of Paris, I've heard the calling of the Lord. The time has come to take our city back. We'll save our Paris, expose this heathen gypsy horde. Before we're overrun, we must attack.
Hunt down the gypsy and the soldier. Don't let them flee and vanish in the night. We'll find the gypsy and the soldier. While they are free, our torches will burn bright.
Fire, fire, smoke and flame. Esmeralda, where are you? In this dark I call your name. Is there all that I can do?
Esmeralda!
You should have minded your own business.
It had to be somebody's business.
I need a place to hide you. Wait here.
Wait! Esmeralda!
What have I done for Esmeralda? Why did I hear her words inside my head? And still I think of Esmeralda, with my career and body left for dead.
Somewhere she is
lost.
Where is the girl called Esmeralda?
Quasimodo!
Esmeralda! You came back!
Yes. I need your help.
Anything.
This was the closest place I could think to hide him.
Why is he here?
He's been hurt, Quasimodo. He needs a place to recover. Oh. Can you keep him safely hidden somewhere?
No, Master!
Please, Quasimodo, help me!
Lay him there!
I promise it won't be for long. When he's stronger, send him to me.
Where?
The place we gypsies hide. The Court of Miracles.
Court of Miracles?
Here. When you wear this woven band, you hold the city in your hand.
Esmeralda, quickly. Frollo and the Cathedral Guard will be back soon.
I must go now. Thank you.
How can you let her leave?
Go after her. Bring her back.
After her? No, I can't.
You must. She was right here and you let her go.
No, I can never go out there again.
She's in danger out there.
You have to save her.
Save her? Me?
What's the matter? Are you afraid?
Of course he's afraid. And he should be.
But that's what makes you a hero.
Doing what you're afraid of. A hero or a saint?
Oh, wait. You mean like Saint Off? Saint Off? What's your name again?
Saint Aphrodisias, the Bishop of Béziers. I was beheaded by a mob in Place Saint-Cyr. And though I made a choice I did not know would bring my grisly martyring, I wouldn't change a thing. For I kept safe and free the Holy Family. Date and palm. I offered shelter to her who is Notre Dame. If that's what I could do, then Quasimodo, you can too.
But even if I could go out there, how could I even find her?
The amulet she gave you. When you wear this woven band,
you hold the city.
What is it? Just a web and a jewel?
It doesn't mean anything.
No, it must be a clue made with guile and art.
And she gave it to you because she knows you're smart.
Think, Quasimodo.
Is it hopeless?
Or can you see in it something you've seen before?
Seen before? Wait, I know this. Look at this line. That's a bridge. That's a street. And this jewel, it must show where we're supposed to meet.
You've done it, Quasimodo, this for certain.
It's a map. It's a map. Look, it's the city seen from above.
It's a map from above.
I'll do it. I'll find Esmeralda. I'll go out there while it's dark and cold and bring her back.
Just like the angel who warned Joseph he must flee,
I'll save Esmeralda.
Her angel will be me.
I'll give her sanctuary, somewhere safe to hide, protected at my side, a little like a bride.
Like saints and
for her I will be strong. And
our flight into Egypt will last your whole life long. Yes, our flight into Egypt will last
our whole.
How did I get here?
Gypsy girl!
What happened? Frollo,
need bandages.
Quiet!
Sorry.
Quasimodo?
Oh, hi!
That?
No! Oh. No one! Oh.
Quasimodo, I heard something. Was that you?
No.
Talking to someone?
Yes! My friends!
Ah. This has been quite an eventful day, hasn't it?
At night, too!
The fires. Couldn't be helped, I'm afraid. I am so glad that you were up here, safe from it all. Well, I'm afraid I can't stay-
Story!
What?
A story, master! A story of Saint... Aphrodisius!
Good memory. But you, seem distracted. Is there something troubling you, my boy?
Wait, troubling? No! No, no!
Quasimodo, you know I'm looking for Esmeralda for her own good. If you have any information about where she might be, it would be of great help to her. And to me. Did she say anything about where she might be? Did she tell you where she stays?
I...
Yes?
And the hunchback looked his master in his piercing eye.
Quasimodo?
And for the very first time in his life,
he told her...
No! I do not know! I swear!
Very well, then. That is the answer. Relax, dear boy. I'm not angry with you.
I know what little choice you had. You were seduced by Esmeralda. I know you don't mean to be bad, and you feel gratitude for all I've done. Why, there are times I almost think of you as my son.
Excuse me, Your Grace.
Don't interrupt me here.
Beg pardon, but I have good news. My men believe they have found the gypsy's hiding place.
The Court of Miracles.
Yes, they call it so.
Well then, it seems their miracles have run out. We will attack at dawn. You see, my boy, everything is going to be fine.
We will find her, never fear, and then I will rejoin you here to cheer her capture in our cheery sanctuary.
I have to go. I have to find Esmeralda. I have to warn her and the others.
You? No, me!
You? How could you possibly? You can't even speak.
Well, you can barely walk.
You don't know where anything in the city is.
That's not true. I see all from up here. Besides, Esmeralda gave this to me. It's a map.
Give that to me.
No, Esmeralda gave it to me.
Yes, but I need it to find her.
I will find her.
You don't be ridiculous.
Hey!
Something must be done. Surely you can see realistically who's got the knack here. Clearly I'm the one who can save the day. You'd be in the way. So, hey, come back here.
Odo.
And Phoebus.
Darkening streets of Paris.
Though the hunchback felt a thrill of fear at once more setting foot outside Notre Dame.
out here once again beyond my parapets of stone, wishing I were feeling so much braver. Stealing through the twisted streets of night toward the unknown, still I must do anything to save her.
Creeping past the ghostly shadows, besides which beggars slept.
They ducked into the shadows to avoid being seen.
By a pair of women in their window,
holding candles which sputtered in the gathering fog.
The curfew sounded long ago, and the streets were becoming blacker and more deserted with every moment.
They could distinguish nothing of the mass of buildings,
except the black roofs at strange acute angles.
And the labyrinth of alleys and bridges like a ball of thread tangled by a cat.
I think you've got us lost.
No!
Where the hell are we?
It looks like a cemetery.
Here. Oh, good God, look, you've led us in the completely wrong direction.
What's that?
What? I didn't hear anything.
Welcome to the Court of Miracles! You're very clever for having found our little hiding place. Too bad you won't live to talk about it. Get them inside. Maybe you've heard of a terrible place where the scoundrels of Paris collect in a lair. Maybe you've heard of a mythical place called the Court of Miracles.
The Court of Miracles!
Brother, you're there, where the lame can walk. And the blind
can see!
But the dead don't talk, so you won't be around to reveal what you found. We have a method for spies and intruders, not terribly different from bees in a hive. But here in the Court of Miracles, where it's a miracle if you get out alive.
Cursed.
My apologies, gentlemen, for your imminent demise. Any last words? I thought not. It's always sad when a life's at its finish. I have to admit to a bit of a pain, but we must protect at all costs our secrets. It's our lives or yours.
So you're going to hang!
These men are my friends!
More than we are, apparently. How could you betray us like this?
I haven't betrayed you.
Oh, no? Then what do you call telling them of our hiding place? Esmeralda, I knew that you were no good.
You should be thanking her! We've come to warn you. Frollo knows of your hiding spot. He plans on attacking at dawn.
All right, calm down. How do you know of this?
Master told me!
And why should we believe either of you? You're Frollo's slave, and him? He's a soldier. And we do not trust soldiers!
He's not a soldier anymore.
I'm now just as much of an outcast as any of you.
Clobin, if this is true...
We don't have much time.
We have to get ready to leave.
I'd hoped that we had a few more years here, yes, but... Yes, we must pack now. Yasha! Go! Esmeralda, we have to pack now.
Pack! You're going with them.
Of course. We won't leave one of our own behind.
Thank you, Clobin.
Esmeralda, no.
What would you have me do?
Come with me.
Where?
I don't know. We could start a life together.
You really are a dreamer, aren't you?
Esmeralda! I take you! I keep you safe!
Quasimodo.
In the crypts, maybe. I know all the secrets.
Thank you, Quasimodo, but it would be too dangerous. Not just for me, but for you too.
Fine. Then if you won't come with me, I'll go with you.
You go with her!
You can't do that, Phoebus.
Why not? There's nothing here for me. Maybe there never was.
To become like one of us?
You don't understand what kind of life you would be facing.
Actually, over the past couple of weeks, I think I've gotten a pretty good idea, but I don't care. Here we are, nearly strangers from two worlds that have rarely met. But somehow you have made me
someone new, traveling far on a journey that's the longest I've taken yet. Now I'm asking if you will let me come with you. Though our lives are tattered and torn, all I'm feeling now is reborn. I must be in a place of miracles,
where the blind can see.
In a place of miracles, a miracle you've brought to me. The soldier and the gypsy,
loved in an embrace. In a place of miracles,
I knew I'd never know that warm and loving glow, though I might wish with all my might. No face is hideous as my face was ever meant for heaven's light.
All this time,
it's time I've
been
learned,
certain
your love will be returned.
My life would be spent alone
to one who was born to be
and
alone.
I pretended not
who
to care.
Who means when the laughable can try near?
But now I'm here beside you. No more need for a heart of stone.
Where don't you have a heart of stone?
Set out for lands unknown. Fair lands
will show hope
in
heaven's
light. Will we reach a friendlier shore? Will we find a haven once more? Where we'll be in a place of miracles. Now we leave our
interrupt.
Master!
Congratulations, my boy. You led us right to them. You didn't think our soldiers would really find this place, did you? And so, I finally get to see the Court of Miracles. Not so impressive now, is it? Arrest the gypsy and the traitor.
No. Take me, not Phoebus, please.
No, take me instead.
Oh, how noble you two are. Take them both away. And round up these gypsies and take them to the Bastille.
Sir Oriel, Sam!
Your Grace, don't worry, we'll find him.
You'll never catch him. Clopin will be halfway through the city in no time.
Proceed. My boy, I am very disappointed in you. Take him back to the bell tower. Make sure he cannot leave it!
Paris was often displayed in the square at Notre Dame.
Now, as the wood for a pyre was laid in the square at Notre Dame,
there came some there who sought entertainment, and some who wished all gypsies harm.
But the rumor was growing, a gypsy was going to burn at dawn.
My dear, do you feel as uncomfortable as you look?
I wouldn't give you the pleasure.
Oh, it brings me no pleasure. I'd much rather set you free.
So why don't you?
Because in order to do that, you would need to make me a promise first. You see, I still wish to help you. I still believe that your soul can be saved.
Not in the way you would save it. I'd rather die.
What about Phoebus, your sun god? Would you rather he die as well?
No.
His fate lies in your hands.
Why? Why me of all people? I don't understand!
I don't know! I wish I knew. Sometimes we are drawn to the things that repel us the most.
You truly are a monster!
No! No, Esmeralda. If these past few weeks have truly taught me anything, it's that my curse is I am truly human. Take pity on me. I've deserted myself. You don't know what my love for you is. It is fire. It is hot lead. Gypsy witch, you rouse in me this foolish wish to set you free and take you somewhere I can be your sanctuary. I will save you, sorceress, and raise you up to holiness. Forever we will share a blessed sanctuary.
No!
Love me!
No!
Save
me!
Captain.
Yes, Your Grace.
Is the prisoner there?
Yes, Your Grace.
Bring him in. Perhaps, my dear, this will help you think over what I have offered you. Say your last goodbyes to each other. That is, unless you change your mind. Don't let them stay together too long.
Yes, Your Grace. Esmeralda.
Please, don't.
What's the matter?
Just give me a moment.
Frollo, what has he done to you?
He's offered to set me free.
That's wonderful.
If I give myself to him.
Esmeralda. You must do it. Do whatever you can to save yourself.
That's not what I would call saving myself. But it would save you.
Me?
That would be part of the bargain. He'll spare you if...
Esmeralda, I don't care what happens to me, but do it for yourself.
Never.
Esmeralda, please. Captain, you must go. Jacques, my friend. If I've offered what little I've saved up, couldn't I just...
Save your money, Captain. We'll be back at dawn.
We have so little time to say goodbye.
So let's say it while we have the chance.
I've known soldiers not half as brave as you.
I don't feel very brave. But maybe if there really is this heaven, you so believe it. We'll be able to watch from it together when all of this is over and the world's a better place. I used to believe in the days I was naive that I'd live to see a day of justice dawn. Though I will die long before that morning comes, I'll die while believing still it will come when I am gone.
will be fairer.
Life will be fairer.
Need will be rarer.
Need will be rarer.
Greed will not pay.
Greed will not pay.
Godspeed.
Godspeed.
This bright millennium.
On
its way. Let it come
someday. Things have changed. Someday these dreams will all be real. Till then we'll wish upon the moon. Change will come.
While the city slumbered, Quasimodo sat awake.
As the night crept pitilessly onward,
not one word he uttered, not one movement did he make,
awaiting the inexorable dawn.
Quasimodo, you must try to free yourself.
Don't you see what's going on down there? They're building a pyre.
The girl needs your help.
Quiet! Go away!
You're the only one who can save her now.
You know what happens when I try to help. I make things worse.
You don't believe that.
How do you know what I believe? What do you know of me? What do you know of all the things I feel? You're only made of stone. Who is it that you see? Instead of seeing what I am for real, this twisted flesh and bone. You're a liar. With every new excuse you try out, you only make me want to cry out. Would that I were made of stone. Such good advice. So I has not one single word you said, not any note at all. And you who sound so nice, the more your dreams and fancies fill my head, the farther that I fall. Shut my brain down. If I were senseless, I'd prefer it. Another cockwheel on this turret, spitting rain down to the stone below. I've wasted my faith, believing in saints of plaster. But the only one worth believing in was my master. He's the one who never lied. He told me it was cruel outside. He told me how I had to hide. His words were cold as stone, but they were true. Not like you. Take all the dreams you've sworn. Take all your lies and leave me.
Quasimodo, we'll leave you alone.
All right, Quasimodo, we'll trouble you no longer.
You're right, Quasimodo, we're only made of stone.
We just thought that you were made of something.
Thank you.
now I'm on my own. Never again to wonder what's out there. Let it remain unknown. In my one human eye will never more be dry until the day I die. As if I
the prisoner has been found guilty of entering the city of Paris illegally. Guilty of stabbing a soldier of the church. And guilty of the crime of witchcraft. The sentence is death. I will now give you this opportunity to recant and save yourself. Think of what I have offered you. What is your answer? For the justice of this realm and for the salvation of Paris, it is my sacred duty to send this unholy demon back to hell.
No!
No!
No! No! No! And at that moment, Quasimodo decided.
But, sir, the laws of sanctuary.
I am Archdeacon of this cathedral. I negate the laws of sanctuary. Get the doors open. Break them down if you must.
And as the soldier tried to knock down the church doors, they suddenly saw Quasimodo hurling great stones and giant beams.
As the soldiers pounded out the great doors,
a figure suddenly appeared where Captain Phoebus was being held.
And he was set free
by the heroic Clopin!
And together they rallied the people to fight!
Hear me, people of Paris, how much oppression will you love? Someday your patience will fall.
Wait a second.
stop them.
Until he saw the great bands of molten lead sitting upon the roof.
Up there! He's way up there!
Come on, you saints of stone.
Saints of stone.
Gins and gargoyles.
Blaze of fire.
In the night.
Blaze of fire.
Now, lightning.
Light of lead.
Steaming, boiling.
Streams of lead.
Burning lead. And
let the flames go.
And monsters show your power. Help me to send this raging shower, raining fire on the storm below.
Was my duty.
Duty.
Now things can finally go back to the way that they were before.
No. Can never go back.
We will. You'll see. At last we're free of Esmeralda. Now that she's gone, her poison dies with her. Now that we're free of Esmeralda, we can go on as close as once we were. Here in our sanctuary. Sanctuary.
Sanctuary? No sanctuary without her.
It was a choice. Quasimodo. I could have helped her. Maybe even loved her.
Love? What do you know of love? Who have you ever loved?
I loved my brother. I tried to teach him.
You teach him?
Yes, as I have tried to teach you. But he was wicked. Weak!
No! No, you are the weak one. You're the wicked one, and the wicked shall not go unpunished!
The wicked shall not go unpunished.
Quasimodo, what are you doing? Let go of me! Quasimodo! Stop! Quasimodo! Don't! Wait! What are you doing?
I told you, Master. I'm very strong.
You don't want to hurt me.
Yes, you
advantage.
Quasimodo races to huge hands, and with a great bellow threw his master over the edge of the roof into the abyss below.
Later, in the crypts below Notre Dame, they found two skeletons, one of which holding the other in its embrace. The first was a woman with a woven band around her neck. The second was a man with a crooked spinal column. When they tried to separate the skeleton which he held in his embrace, he crumbled to ash.
More.
morning in Paris. A new day appears, sing the bells of Notre Dame. Ending the tale of your poor balladeers and the bells of Notre Dame.
And we wish we could leave you a moral,
like a trinket you hold in your palm.
But here is a riddle to guess if you can sing the bells of Notre Dame. What makes a monster and what makes a man?
At the people down below me.
All my life I've watched them as I hide up here alone, hungry for these histories they show me. All my life I memorize their faces, knowing them as they will never know me. All my life I wonder how it feels to pass a day not above them, but part of them. In the sun, give me one day of their. All I ask is one to hold forever of their, where they all live on, where what I give, what I care, just to live. Among the millers and the weavers and their wives, through the roofs and gables I can see them. Every day they shout and scold and go about their lives, heedless of the gift it is to be them. If I were in their skin, I'd treasure every instant out there, strolling by the sin. Taste of morning out there, like ordinary men who freely walk up out there. Just one day and then I swear I'll be content with my share. Won't resent, won't despair, old and bent, I won't care.